Oh, hi, good morning everybody. How is everybody doing? Welcome to my new web camera. That is right, I have bought web camera thanks to my sister Meghna Pant. I want to thank her for giving me an early birthday gift. She asked me what I want for my birthday and I'm like, I want a webcam. She's like, that's the weirdest gift I have been asked for. I'm like, I can't afford it myself. So I appreciate it. Thank you to my sister. Couple of things to mention. Today I have a show which is at, I think it's either Traveling Pants or Rant of the Pant. I don't know which one. One of them is there. And tomorrow is Rant of the Pant or Traveling Pants. One of them is there. I don't know which show is when, but there's some show. So just come see. Both are different content. If you've not seen it, tickets are on saurabhpant.com. Again, you can support this podcast on PayPal and Instamojo. And if you're impressed by my camera, don't be jealous. Okay, don't be jealous by this amazing technology that I have. I'm very impressed by it. I'll keep talking about it for at least 2 hours. If you've never seen the show, the way it works is, yes, late OP. Love you too, Harsh Pandey. I don't know who you are, but I love you dearly and I wish we were friends. Vicky Singh, aaj Saturday hai, this is good. Cool. Wrong spellings. Again, I spelled Cyrus Broach, man. I don't know why this autocorrect is fucking making it Cyrus Broach each time. The fourth time this mistake has happened. If you've never seen the show before, the way it works is I have guests and we talk and chit-chat and then I take some questions from Super Chat. If I can't take your question eventually, just don't be sad and mad because there's too many questions for me to take. And also, I know that a lot of people are like, oh, you only take people who pay money. That's the way we keep this podcast running. It's pretty simple. You guys are basically sponsoring the show. So, this is not some whatever. Wrong spelling of Cyrus Bucha and Kunal Vijaykar.
But I'm bored now.
Yeah, Cyrus, I don't think there's stuff. Any I can stop you.
Your introduction was fabulous, but it's the longest since, I think, 47 partition when the Brits said, okay, we're going. And went on for about 2 hours at Gateway of India. I remember my uncle shot himself because it took 2 hours just to finish his speech. But it was beautiful. And I want to thank your sister. Is she very rich? Is she well off?
Well, they just finished off paying some hefty loans and all. So now she has money, apparently. So I'm exploiting that fully.
Is she part of the Prime Minister's Relief Fund or something? Because I believe that's not going to be audited. That's a good place to keep your money.
Yeah, her husband's name is PM Cares.
There you go! There you go!
It's very weird.
It's amazing! The subconscious power that I have of just getting it right all the time. Super.
Yeah.
No, but my point was, is it possible sort of for us to get a webcam each, Kunal and me? We've had some really bad times in the last 5 months. You may not know, but there's this thing called COVID and, you know, there's been very little work and So Kunal, for example, has, you know, he's not been able to take his normal vaccines. Forget the COVID one, just the rabies and the other things that he needs to. Because there's no nurse willing to go upstairs and actually, you know, go into that area of his glutes and, you know, probe and poke and give the relevant vaccine to him. So he has suffered.
So Kunal has a monthly rabies vaccine because he makes sure he gets bitten every month.
No, he has a monthly estrogen
shot to maintain
his gender bias. And also along with that, distemper, rabies, pneumonia. And I think the bacteria have left your body now during COVID because they've got other places to go to. But yeah,
why do you keep piling on into my life?
Stop saying that. I like that child. That could be somebody's child. That child has a mother and father somewhere. You can't be rude. Okay, the Sharmas opposite are angry with you now. Oh, is that a boy or a girl?
I don't. That was a girl.
A girl. All right.
Yeah.
I'm not good with children, you know. I'm not even good with human beings. I'm good with plants. But, you know, do you have any plants? We can play with them for some time.
I actually have a plant, but it died. So
look after the child better than the plant because obviously plants aren't your thing. Oof, that's scary. How old is the child?
I don't know. Who remembers these things? Three.
Five, ten ke beech mein.
Aisa hi kuch.
You should have a round figure. Round figure is important. Yeah.
Yeah. 36, roughly, around that much.
So, Saurabh, I didn't even know. So, that means you're married or this is just something that happened during a tour in California?
I was on the first tour in California and I was just like hanging out with all these people, smoking up and having fun. You know how California is.
You're telling me, yaar. Never been there, but I know everything about it. Like all Indians. Internet. Zindabad. Ding, ding.
Huh. By the way, before hi Kunal, I think you have to be officially greeted as well.
No, it's fine. Cyrus speaks on my behalf most of the time, and let him continue.
Yeah. Listen, all the comments were like, "Hey, best of luck trying to speak." I'm like, I don't really want to. I think this is perfectly fine. Guest to take over.
Guys, let's just get an irrelevant part here. You are married, na? Sorry, I just want to clarify.
I'm very much married. Yes,
so let me
yes,
now
yes,
tell
yes,
Kunal. Kunal, he likes girls, so you please leave him alone now. He's very clearly into the ladies and he's married with a child. I don't want any trouble later. All right, because everybody's a little worried here.
But my heart is broken now.
Your heart is broken because you said you want Pant, no Pant for you. God.
As part of the marital contract, nowhere does it say that you can't have, you can't cheat on the same sex.
Well, in Friends, they're not hello friends. In the original Friends, the Friends that America made, we made one, they made one. You know how we make rockets that didn't go up in space? They made rockets that went up in space, you know, that kind of thing. So in that, apparently that whole thing has been acted out before. Where,
The hello friends thing was so, I realized
elegant,
you had to mention,
elegant, heartwarming.
You have to mention.
Aapko shabd ho chahiye, mere paas hai shabd. Where's my Googles? Where's my Googles? Sorry, brother.
Before we begin, I have to speak about some...
Give us the beating first and then let's make love after that. Come on.
Yeah, so I want to first acknowledge some allegations that were made by you against me in your podcast, Cock and Bull, okay?
Oh my God.
Acknowledge, and Kunal, as a neutral spectator to these allegations by Cyrus, yes. I'd just like to, if you guys can hear these again.
Yeah, I remember.
I didn't hear this properly, but you can tell me what it was.
Okay, I'll explain.
Let's see the explanation, and then I have the WhatsApp chats as my defense for who started these allegations that are perpetuated against me and my office, my noble office.
Are you close? Are you close to my in-laws or something? This sounds like vindictive, this whole attitude. Yeah. I'll just tell you what happened. I hate the phone, okay? And you send me a text saying, whatever, Saurabh Pant show, do this, do that. And as usual, I send some stupid remark. And then, of course, you send some stupid remark. And then it wouldn't end because neither of us wanted it to end. So I was telling Amit and the boys in the podcast that these egos of these bloody comedians, me, myself included, is we want the last word. Joby, a last word has to happen. It's not even who's funnier. Just who ends it. So I just went on and on. You went on and on. I said, fuck, I don't want to ever text this guy again.
Listen. The allegations made were that these comedians just keep starting jokes and just tell me the point of your conversation and get to the point, okay? That was the allegation made against this, my noble office. Just,
oh my God!
Just against my message.
I think I need a lawyer. One minute. Mr. Salve ko bulao phone pe.
Mr. Brocha, Saurabh Pant. See, respect right up top. Mr. Brocha, like a nice person, right?
Yeah.
Been talking about Kunal Vijayakar, but no, it was correct. Mr. Brocha, only not Brocha this time.
Not Brocha.
Is it older phone? Older phone remembers us.
Been talking to Kunal Vijayakar about having both of you on my YouTube live. Kunal is free. All the dates given, 11 a.m., whichever one suits you. Cyrus Brocha, who is this Kunal Vijayakar? that is the first. I don't want to buy anything from him. And then I said some retired food critic fellow. And then it started. Right? And we went on and on for about to a point where it was like nobody knew when to end this conversation. In fact, Cyrus was like, get to the fucking point. So yeah, I just want to say that these allegations are false. And Cyrus was the one who started it.
I just want to also say that while comedians do this, it's even worse when the non-comedian does it because he thinks I'm with someone who thinks he's funny. I need to be like that. And that also doesn't end. And sometimes it's not even close to funny. So that's very painful. It's like piles all over. Ouch. But I actually had a very good time with that texting. I actually enjoyed your texting a lot. It was all as close to an orgasm as I've had in the lockdown.
Oh, you know what? It was very exciting to me to be riffing with you. Even on text format, because the key I realized is WhatsApp texting is to do it on WhatsApp web. I don't know if you're familiar with WhatsApp web, Cyrus.
Of course! What the fuck is he talking about? Stop bullying us, all right? Don't take a couple of old lions out to, you know, chase deer which they can't see, which just look
Cyrus,
like.
I know what WhatsApp web is. It's a bit of a mouthful. WhatsApp web. I know.
That's your contribution to our entire conversation. That you know what WhatsApp web is. I want to remove this child from the class, Saurabh. As soon as possible. And get your child back. What's her name?
Nayantara. She's disappeared into the wilderness now. Yeah. She's,
sweet.
I don't know why she's.
Imagine, she actually likes you. Isn't that lovely to have somebody who actually likes you? At the moment, at least.
Is that why you create children? Is that, I have a friend of mine who's, No, okay, Cyrus, yeah, you go ahead. You have some opinions.
No. I was just agreeing with you. The thought, when you actually have them looking at you with the, you know, stars in their eyes at that age, it ends at some point. This will change. Minus, are you older now? They hate me. But I think this is the age where you got Nayantara right now, where they actually look at you like you're God, you're beautiful, you're lovely, you're fantastic. They're like what puppies are forever. Of course, puppies become dogs, but they still remain loving, generally speaking. So this is my experience and my gift to you is enjoy this period video as much as you can. When she's 40, she wouldn't want you around her friends. You'll be that creepy father who wants to be funny and young, and you'll just get the slap every time you go there. So don't. I'm just warning you. Kunal's like that. He's always around these young girls, school girls and all that, and everybody's uncomfortable here because he's older than the mothers, you know. I mean, it's just not right.
Look, I can't be part of this conversation. I have no children. I don't know what to say now. But the young mothers are like,
what? That's what you got out of our conversation again? You're not even paying attention. How do we delete him? You guys, come on, technology, delete Kunal. Delete. Damn you, delete. Where's the bloody buttons? Oh, there is a delete.
My son the other day, I think we were discussing about
you've who got more than one. You Biharis, I tell you, you're not reading the AMDA. We sent the memo to you guys. Yaar. Hum do, hamare ek. It's all switched.
Aaron, you had two kids as well. Don't you have two children?
Parsis are a minority. They've been told by the government to repopulate as soon as possible and pollinate all the flowers as possible and, you know, pull in 20% Parsis or whatever you can to save the tribe. Another story. Please, another story.
But doesn't it come with like some crazy amount of like that tribe nature where you have a child and you feel such pride where you're like, look at this, what I've created to further our civilization. Is there any pride attached to that? No.
Yeah, but your pride will stay forever. I'm talking about from her point of view where she thinks of you as God. That's a lovely period. I saw the way she looked at you. It was lovely. It was fantastic. You're never going to get that again. Yeah.
So my five-year-old son, we were discussing who his best friend is, and he said his best friend is Papa. Okay, so this is, and I'm like, oh, this is the fucking nicest thing.
Is it
thing, okay?
Papa CJ the comedian?
Yeah, the Papa CJ the comedian. You know, the worst part is on my phone, my dad's name is under Papa CJ. So Papa CJ comes first, then my real dad. I'm like, this is really confusing and irritating.
So there are things. Papa CJ. He is a granddad. Why is he called Papa? Okay, got it. This is terrible. We've done.
But cut injustice. To 2 weeks later, my son was playing with a friend of his and he told me to go away. And I was like, oh, this, I thought I was your best friend last week and this has changed in 2 weeks flat. We have been already demoted.
I feel like hugging you. I empathize so much. I have no idea. Because the lack of respect you get on for a bad show on stage will never compare to the lack of respect from the family. It's just amazing. Wait till he becomes a fan and loves the EPL and watches Liverpool and you walk in front of the screen or you talk to him while he's watching. Wait till the guy, oh boy, you're in for it. You're in for it, bro. It's going to be a hard life. I say leave now. You know, just send a stipend home. You're doing well, touch wood. You know, send some money home. You do your bit as a father, but just leave now. Keep your respect and dignity. You've lost your hair already. Keep something, brother. Keep something, please.
I've had actual like daydream fantasies about doing exactly this. I've explored this thoroughly. Where I'm like, if I just disappear, what's the worst that's going to happen? Is that I can fuck off to Singapore and just stay there for 3-4 months, and people are like, maybe he's dead. Like that's the upside of it. But I've never been able to follow through. Have you ever had these daydream fantasies of just leaving and never returning?
I'm basically paralyzed neck upwards. There's not much I can do alone. So without my wife or mother, more mother, I'm quite useless. For example, I didn't know that, you know, underwear have to be cleaned by somebody and then given to you.
Yeah.
I just presumed it just happened. And just one day when both of them were out of the house and the same underwear was lying in the bucket for days, you know, I learned a very harsh lesson. You know, which is why I wear underwear. It's just a pointless experience after going through all that.
Let's have a first question to you, which is that are you even wearing underwear during the lockdown?
Will you mean?
Yeah.
Get up, stand up. Take your time. It'll take a long time. We can't see anything, Baba.
Yeah.
We couldn't see anything. Go back, bend over, remove your shorts, and then let me throw a golf ball. Lovely.
That's it. Lovely. I've worn only this during lockdown, nothing else. Although I've been stepping out, I've been stepping out and doing shit here and there. I go to Cyrus's house for a meal. I drive around the block just generally, aimlessly. I do these kind of things now.
I'll tell you what happened. It's because we're not getting gigs. He basically took on a gig as an Uber driver. So he just keeps driving around waiting for someone to call him because in Prabhadevi, not that many use Uber for some reason. So the other thing you do is you steal chappals from outside Siddhivinayak. Which
temples.
Is like, he goes there. Somebody goes into
absolutely. It requires me to bend and I cannot do that. Bending and picking up chappals is not happening.
How you've changed.
But you remember those things which are used to pick up the dog shit? You can use these different devices. I just think you need to upgrade yourself with theft.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea. So no bending at all.
no bending. You just pick it up and put it and steal chappals. It's a very good idea.
What do you do with all the steel chappals, solid chappals?
Well, you sell them on Amazon or something, I guess. I mean, you can make about 2,000-3,000 bucks at least. I think that's a good living. It's not bad.
At the moment, that's a very good living. 2,000 bucks is a lot of money at the moment.
Okay, by the way, I got to talk about how I'm very excited about having both of you on. Okay, this is the part where I'm just going to...
You don't look excited. You look like you're in coma. You look like you're in pain.
That's because I have children. I have not slept in 3 days. But barring that, I'm very excited. I was doing research, by the way, again, and I didn't realize that the week that wasn't is still on the air. So what I want to ask you guys is why...
It came out all wrong. Thanks. Tarif mat karo, bhai. Tarif mat karo.
No, it's 2006, I think, was when we were doing...
You didn't add the important, relevant word, which is why. Why is it still on the air?
No, but I realize, I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong. You guys do the show, which tends to have a kind of different audience versus the podcast, which tend to have a different audience. So I'm curious, how many people are still fans? How many people come up to you even right? And what kind of people come up and say, hey, I love the show on Week That Was. I love Week That Wasn't. After like 14 years.
No one's ever said, I love the show. Some people say that, they just ask me, what is Kunal's real gender? Because, you know, when you play a female politician in her 60s from different corners of India, I mean, you know, that's just something special. But it's an older audience, which we don't mind. What can we do? No young people have heard of us or speak to us. It's very embarrassing. So we use your name and, you know, that kind of thing to push our agenda across. We are doing a show. It's with Kunal Cyrus and Saurabh Pant. Ah, okay. Then, you know, the little bell rings and then they're interested. It's okay.
No, but it's true. See, I went once for some event.
But why are you pulling your shirt all the time? Is your bra coming out? What's going on there? You're pulling it. It's distracting me. I can't see.
Some Amish.
Put your hands up and talk. You're like a mad child. No pulling the shirt. Sorry, go on.
So I went for some Amish no pulling the shirt. Event.
go on. Tell your story.
One, but I've forgotten that one. So I went for some.
No pulling the shirt out drinking coffee from the mug. Sorry. I don't know who watches. Who will watch? I mean, really. Maybe
come back to you on this one. I'll come back to you on this.
I swear I'll keep quiet. Just tell the story. But if it's not funny or interesting, I want you to choke yourself on camera. So this or about something nice to show.
It's not, tell the story. It's not funny. Judge it. It's not funny. So, shall I tell the story?
Okay. Tell the bloody story, man. Tell the bloody story.
So I went to this Amish Tripathi, was doing something with Shankar Gupta, something at the...
Why are you throwing names? You think Pant doesn't have friends? His bloody parents were income tax champions. He's got bloody friends on the list. I know Amish Tripathi, I know... Who cares?
Neither of them are my friends. I just went for this event. Okay.
Name proper. Pull your shirt.
So I went because I wanted to leave in 5 minutes. I went and sat on the last row. Okay. And there, this bald fellow comes and sits next to me, who I recognize as Saurabh Pant. Who I've watched before. So we were chatting. Remember, listen, no, so we are chatting.
Now we can't edit the story because you put him in. He was going to edit the story.
And we're chatting, and suddenly a horde of young girls and boys come and start walking towards us. Okay? So I thought they've recognized me. And they're all coming for autographs and all, okay? And they all looked through me completely and went straight to Saurabh Pant. And that is when I discovered that, boss, we've missed one whole generation of people. And I was standing there quietly helping people take photographs.
But at least they didn't do what...
I left quietly. I put my tail between my legs and left quietly after that. I said, khalas, my career is over. Nobody's really recognized me anymore.
Forget about that. Why do you tell such boring stories? It's terrible.
It's
so boring. Now, my age group that watches is even older after this story. It's ridiculous what you've done. Just in one, but at least it's not sort of, you know, mine are worse because I remember in Loveline days in MTV, if I went with Malaika anywhere, they would ask me to take the photograph of Malaika and the person all the time. It was so embarrassing for me everywhere. I mean, just take a photo.
But have you seen what Malaika looks like and what Saurabh Pant looks like?
Yeah.
But now it's difficult to tell. But in the old days, Malaika was very pretty and Saurabh was, well, Saurabh, did you ever have hair as a young baby?
I was born this way and I continued on this path. I was determined to stick to the theme that God had given me.
You were born on the same day that the 36 Chambers of Shaolin released and Dad said, yeah, I like this. And before you know it, are you a Kung Fu specialist of any kind?
I have been a Kung Fu specialist for a really long time. I was born, I became bald. See, I have moves. I have really great moves.
I like, could tell.
There you go. People look at me and listen, these arms, they don't look lethal, okay?
They are.
If I come at your face, okay, you fucking beware, okay?
I'm scared.
I'm chop you up like lettuce.
Don't chop, man. Don't chop. Peace, brother. Peace, peace. Peace, brother. Peace. Peace out, brother. Peace, peace. Peace. What is the peace sign? I keep forgetting. Just remind me, I've got Alzheimer's. What is the peace sign? Yeah, that's it. Yeah. Message for Kunal from all the old people, all the kids who met him that day. Message for Kunal. Yeah.
Oh, but the point was that I'm a big fan of both of you guys, is what I wanted to get out. And I'll tell you when I became a fan of Cyrus, okay? I don't know if you even remember this. I think MTV, there was all this like programming and all that nonsense. And I remember there was just like all these people making a lot of effort. And I'm not saying that you weren't.
You don't have to.
There was just you sitting in some random garden with a plastic chair talking shit for 35 minutes. And I was like, this is great. This is fucking such an, it's so refreshing from everybody going like, hey guys, this is Channel Blah. And I'm like, this is just a dude who's...
And I was just the Mali. Can you imagine? You know, not really in charge of a garden, just cleaning it here and there. Yeah.
So
how old were you, sort of, to put it in perspective? Five?
I don't... No, six? I think 13 maybe. I don't know how old I was. 13. I'm 38 years old. You're 56.
I'm...
1?
49, August 7th, 49, Baba. I was born.
Oh, I got confused because you were celebrating Kunal Vijayakar's birthday and he was 56 that time. See, what a great
save. Yes, yes. Kunal is 57.
Yeah. No, look, he's younger than me. I know we look the same age, but he's younger than me.
You know the sad part, Saurav, can I tell you something? Kunal and I started hanging out in the 1990, if I remember correctly. And there's almost 8-year difference between us. And at that time, it showed. Because he was 30-something and I was 20-something. Clearly,
you were 18, man.
And my pals used to actually say things like his uncle coming and all that. We used to tease him a little bit for drinks and stuff. And then as the years go by, the biggest insult I've faced was, I remember about 5-10 years back, when somebody said, so you and Kunal were in class together. I just completely shattered me. These are things, you know, when you tell a fat woman she's pregnant, you know, these things you can't come back from, you know, they just mean. Or like the first time a kid looks at you and says, uncle, bald, you know, uncle, the first time you heard it, it just kills you because it's coming from a neutral source. There's nothing you can do once it's gone. They didn't, Lena Dena, they just said it. It's from the heart, very painful.
Yeah, but uncle is now, I know Maharashtra just started calling me Ajoba, okay? Literally, I had somebody calling me Ajoba the other day. And he was an old man with white hair. He said, and I was in a temple, so I couldn't even abuse him at that point. I was like, Mata! Namaste.
You don't have to leave the recording. Every time you tell us a boring story, don't leave the recording. They'll still stand by you. I'll stand by you, Ajoba. You're the Ajoba for life. You're the grandfather of the nation. We need one.
By the way, there's about 1,000 people here who are watching right now. 956 people current. Yeah.
Wow, not bad.
Yeah.
This is the biggest audience we've ever had, huh?
Yeah, I've never had this kind of audience before.
Will you stop talking when the host is talking? Stop trying to cow footage all the time, old man. I'm sorry. I'll use the ruler on Kunal. Whatever happens.
Why is the ruler still in wrapping is the question. It's just dirty.
We have a give back policy on Amazon here. We want to keep that. As all Indians, we use it for a few days and send it back. That way, everything's good. Yeah. Sorry.
So, there's Super Chat. Do you guys know Super Chat? Are you guys familiar with Super Chat? Super Chat is when people pay extra money to give comments and questions. So, this is just...
Haan ji. Mujhe pata hai. I know all these young terms. Super Chat.
But they pay you the money.
I mean, YouTube takes 30% and then my OML guys take 15% and then GST takes 18%. So, eventually, I get like 5 rupees.
Yes, I've heard that OML is very generous. Sorry, go on.
Omkar Subekar says Cyrus says is OP, which is overpowered. Do you know OP?
I had an uncle called OP Sidhwa, but I guess that would not be.
No, Cyrus, there was a mathematics book in the 1940s. OP Sinhal.
Sinhal, yeah. Sinhal classes. Kunal, I paid for Sinhal classes, and then after 1 month, I stopped going. They didn't give the money back. I really wanted to.
But you went to
somebody died.
You went to classes called Sinhal. I went to a class called Pinge. You know what Pinge sounds like?
Pinge worked for Sinhal and started his own class.
Pinge was outside Dadar station. It was very Maharashtrian class.
Yeah.
So my parents were in the income tax side and I was a terrible student and I went to OP Sinhal classes and my dad just put in a word to him saying, just try and focus on this boy. And OP Sinhal was like, he's not come for 2 months. So what I do was, I used to go, my dad used to leave home at, I think, about 9:15. I used to go to the class and then have energy drink and come back home timing when my father's exit was there. So for 2 months I was doing that, then Sinhal basically tattled me out to my dad. And so that's the reason I'm a bad student is Ibrahim OP Sinhal. I've completely forgotten about OP Sinhal. Even you didn't go for a month.
Legends. Exactly the same. See, the problem with our parents now, it's too late to explain to them, is that they think they know what's best for the child. With Nayantara and with whoever my kids, I forget their names, we should not make these mistakes. We don't know what's good for the child. You can't. Kunal was pushed into science stream and he failed twice. All right? They sent him a second time. He failed the year and they said, no, go back. Now, if you fail in science, that means you don't have a head for it. Now, you don't make the guy go twice. But this is the kind of guy who built the bridges in Bombay which collapsed.
Have you ever had anybody who ducked his HSC twice on your show? Two times I ducked my HSC. Very bad.
And after tuitions, he got less marks. That's the best part.
I did. And the second time I appeared, I got less marks.
Super. 1 second. So you did get HSC. How much did you get the first time round? And what did you fail in?
I failed in maths and physics. And I got 5 marks in mathematics. And the second time I appeared, I got 3.
Listen, 5 and 3 is just like you're not even trying. Like you're not even making a little bit of effort to get like little more.
But what about that tutor? He spends the whole year teaching. He's got a student who got 500. If he gets 6, he's done something for the family.
You know how these coaching classes have those photographs where they take a laddu and put it in the top of the mouth? They should have one of Kunal Vijayakar where they're taking a laddu out of his mouth. Like, give it back.
Saurabh, they should remember in the old days, the Hajams used to have all the big stars in the background which have never come to the salon. Yeah. So Salman's haircut and Jackie Shroff and what have you. I'm saying for OP Sinhal and those guys, you, me and Kunal, we should be there, you know. 3, 7, 2. I think it would inspire a generation, man. This is a great idea. I'm going to copyright it. Call my lawyer.
But I've generally never heard of anyone getting 5 and 3.
Just, that's amazing. I remember Alec Padamsi telling us, Kunal is a special talent, and that's true. It's not easy, really. Oh, can I riff for just a reference context here quickly for a second? They used to do a play called I'm Not Bajirao. I don't know if you've seen it.
Oh, I love that play. What a
which
play
made
that
Baman
was,
really famous, and Sudhir Joshi, the thespian Marathi legend. Kunal had a prominent role as a drug pusher there. And his problem was, one set of lines was to do with number and time. Okay? So he has to tell the girl that if you don't come by... what is the line, Kunal? Say the full line. Yeah.
If you don't come by 6:30 tomorrow, you will not turn 21.
Yeah. Huh? She has to pay him by 6:30 tomorrow. Now what happens? Yeah. Give us the real thing.
No, you only do it. That is your better.
So the line is 6:30 tomorrow, you don't turn 21. If you don't come by 6 o'clock tomorrow, you won't be 20. And Baman's character is already 20. Already 20, beta. 21.
And the worst one is that on stage, and you know, Baman and Sudhir Joshi would stand in the wings to just listen to my mistakes.
Yeah. And I'd heckle him.
If you don't come by 6:30 tomorrow, you will not be 6:45. And then they would laugh. He made a mistake again.
This guy was forced to do science, do maths, which is really a problem for him. So unfair. And that poor tutor, must have joined Indian Idol or something, you know, because I think that his life must have just changed after this experience. So I think, what was the, somebody was saying something, we just took off.
No, there's a lot of people saying lots of things. People are,
what is OP? What is OP?
OP is overpowered. It's basically a gaming term when you... You know what? It's Cyrus, honestly, I'm just pretending to understand what other people have told me. Even I don't fucking
But just lie it. Like you always do. Because I'm going to believe it anyway.
a comedian of ours called Vipul Goyal says OP stands for Om Puri, which I think is good. It's a compliment. It's basically a positive thing. It's a positive thing. Is that you're as talented as Om Puri. It's the new way to go.
It means you may be as dead as Om Puri also.
We were both
where did that come
we were
from?
Trying to avoid that joke and
I know
like,
was it necessary really. I mean when you're trying to be funny you're terrible, when you're trying not to be funny you're terrible, when you're trying to be sensitive you're terrible, insensitive you're terrible, you're just terrible. I think get up and show your shorts. It's the only thing that's saving our show now. Stand up for your country.
At the end of the show I'll stand up again.
By then, he'd have left. You think Saurabh's going to stay here? He's being nice for 5 minutes.
Listen, we've done 3-hour shows, so I'm absolutely fine. I have nothing better to do on a Saturday. This is all good. You guys are going to run out of patience way before I do.
You're talking
show.
To people who got 3 on 100 and 5 on 100. You really think we have lots to do? What potential job offers are coming our way?
No, but listen, Kunal, I genuinely got to ask you, did you actually get 3 or 5 or is it a comedic trope?
I don't know. I got 5 on 100 in the first year. And then I not only that, I decided not to just repeat my two subjects, but I decided to repeat the whole course, HSC Science. And I got 3 on 100. And I also remember walking into the physics laboratory for the practical examination and just staring at it and saying, why am I here? Why am I here? And I left. I just walked out. So obviously, I was going to fail. But it's not. It's not a comic thing. It's a real thing. I'm not that funny, actually. I said two stories.
Einstein actually had the same reaction in a lab once. Why am I here? Yeah. And then, of course, he created relativity and this and that. Went to great heights.
So I created relativity.
Crossroads.
Yeah.
Science's loss was bathroom painting's gain. Because, I mean, he's gone through so many different things that he's done. He's actually a very talented artist, by the way. Saurabh, if you want your house done, during COVID, something painted for you. He does Ganesh idols on his own. He makes them for a lot of people. So he's actually a very talented. Kunal, we need to sell you now because there's nothing else we can do.
It's okay. It's all right.
But he's the artist. Yeah.
Are the paintings behind actually yours? I will believe anything right now.
One is a Hussein, which he stole.
This one is mine. It's a fellow called Gorjala. And those two are
Gorjala is a French painter from the Blue Period.
Yeah, I remember.
You, of course. We've discussed it many a time and often.
Mangesh Gorjala.
Mushwa is the pronunciation. Yeah, you're right.
Oh, yeah.
You have to get that
He used to have his vada pav with baguettes. I remember that.
The only Frenchman who ate vada pav every day. You're right. And actually. It is the country.
One vada in a giant baguette. It was really, people are like, dude, your commitment is commendable to this character.
Sorry, go on.
Yeah. No, go ahead. Riffing is the best. Yeah, please.
No. I don't want to interrupt Kunal's story. He was finishing his story and we killed it.
My story is over. No, it's over. Nothing. There's no story.
He's got something in his mouth now.
Yeah. You just decided that. I mean, the host will decide when we eat. You can't just. What are you doing? I mean, this is informal and this is downright rude. You're being rude now, Kunal. Pull your shirt and stand up and show us your pants.
I'm hungry now.
Just put out a request. All those who are watching live, if they want to see Kunal's legs, this is the time to see him.
If you want to see Kunal's legs, and if Kunal is fine with that, we have to also.
He's fine
Kunal's
with that. If it's popular demand, demand, then he has to do it.
Everyone wants to see Kunal's legs, please type out #, justice for Kunal's legs. That's the way we work.
That's right.
And we'll see that. Because, by the way, Kunal, if you want to eat, then please go ahead and eat. That's not a problem. This show is super casual. Don't reveal it yet.
You make money on these things, don't you? Saurabh, you can
charge. Exploit everybody. Yeah.
Kunal,
there's a lot of ambitious money coming in.
Yeah. We can't charge for your legs. Just stop it now, right?
Okay, I got to take a few super chats and then I got to talk to you about many things like Hello Friends also, which I think you've been talking about for the last 2 weeks everywhere. Like, both of you have been going on defending. Like, I remember on week that wasn't you mentioned Hello Friends about 12 times in the episode just to prevent people from making the joke. Yeah.
Well, I got more than 100 calls, requests for interviews. At the very best moments of my career, I've never got more than 3. And two of them are generally just asking for parking and things like that. So I'm just amazed at that. So I said, we have to address, the nation needs to know. And while the murder investigation is being carried out by one man in his channel, so he doesn't have the space and bandwidth to deal with this, I thought we had to take it head on, chest on, and accept full responsibility for something we did without drinking. No one was drinking. After that, everyone started drinking. That's a separate story.
By the way, this is how seminal that show is. I am getting calls from journalists to ask my opinion on the show. that's how it's been. I've had three separate journalists say, hey, what do you think of Hello Friends? I'm like, why? But by the way, wouldn't that be a better news?
Sort of, it's bigger than us. Do you get it? It's bigger than us. It's just huge. Go on.
That would be a much better primetime news is they are discussing whether Hello Friends is better than Friends. Like, that would be Arnav screaming about that.
Can I tell you the embarrassing part really for the journalists is they all want to come to only one question. But before that, they say, tell us about the show, any memories. But all cock all, you know, that's cock all. What they want to ask is, why did you do the show? That's all they want to ask. It's one question for which they disguise because they're all nice people. Nobody wants to be rude on your face. Sometimes we should call it, shoot, why are we in this fuck all show? What are you doing there? Just get to the point. Let me answer it and move on. But yeah,
so,
it was fun.
So why were you on the show is the question. Since you want to come.
Kunal was working with Ajit Pal, who was the director, and they did a show, a Three's Company ripoff. By the way, no one's mentioned that, called Baat Ban Jaye. Baat Ban Jaye or Banegi Apni Baat? Which one was it?
Baat Ban Jaye. Baat Ban Jaye.
Huh. And which wasn't the worst show ever. And then they decided to do a thing of Friends. And Kunal, you tell the story because I don't know how they roped us in. I tried not to.
No, that's simple enough. Ajit Pal got this great idea to rip the show off. He's already done a ripoff of.
I mean, that's not fair to Ajit Pal because everybody in India was ripping off everything.
Everybody was doing it.
We didn't have the concept of law. Law came in 1996 or something, as far as I know.
And the world was not as small as it is now. Yeah, there were only a few elite people on video who had video players and video machines that had seen Hello Friends.
Talking to Saurabh, like he woke up in 2011. Yeah, okay, go on.
Yeah. Yeah, so Ajit Pal had the idea. Yeah, and
no, he got this brilliant idea that your friends with Cyrus would be roping Cyrus and his whole team of MTV MTV VJs would be a good profile for the show. So I was responsible in casting all of them, and then we realized none of them could speak Hindi, man, and it's a Hindi show.
But that wasn't the problem. I wish it was only language. Anyway, go on.
Yeah, that's it. I've finished my
story. I'll do the problem. The problem with that whole damn show, forget the bad acting, the poor language skills, the whatever technical issues. The problem was he just translated the whole thing, right? So I think that was a real issue because when they've done, everybody does loves Raymond or some Office or whatever, they've localized it slightly. You know, they've made some effort. You can't just translate it and then change it because it's culturally clashing with your head. For example, that David Swimmer character loses the wife to another woman, as we discussed in your Privileged show just in the beginning. And that's funny, right? Not to be, you know, gender biased, but that's funny. But when he loses, but they change it to her going for another guy, which is a general tragedy that you'll see in any romance. You know, the wife leaves the husband for another guy. So I was trying to fight. I fought over that. I said, but that's not funny. That's sad. And poor Nikhil was left looking at his shoes after that because, you know, he just felt sad. Where Ross is actually very awkward about the whole girl thing, which sets up the pace for the whole beginning of the show, if I remember correctly. But
no, but you know, I met a very senior Zee TV producer who used to produce Antakshari. Yeah. Huh. And he came up and told me, you know, tum log ye show karte ho, kabhi chalega nahi, kabhi nahi chalega. So I said, why? Ye culture ke khilaf hai hamare. I said, so what do you mean? Dekho, ye ladka ladki ek dusre ke lap pe baithte hai, ye karte hai, wo karte hai. Hamare show mein dekho, sab pair padte hai. You know, ab aisa show banao jo sab, everybody touches everybody's feet.
But you can't bend. You can't bend. End of the show.
But that is true.
But the Hello Friends, which is like the friends being really respectful towards each other, would have been such a
it would have been called Hello Janab. Hello Janab would have been the actual translation. And yeah,
very respectful. It's like, haan Janab, main aapse binti leta hoon ki maine aapke saath cheating kiya. And then he's like, arey nahi. And then it's great. This is a very nice cultural show. I think that's the version of Friends we should see.
No, we would have paused and the Shanai would have played for 15 minutes in the background while a Parag Sari ad ran. I had that vision. You know, nobody asked me. Nobody ever asked me, you know, just ignore me. Next thing you know, this is what it is.
I think you were talking about Anand Neelakantan about something and he was talking about TV. And very funny dude, by the way. Like, that was a really funny episode.
He's really talented guy, funny, you know. Yeah. I should have done, as usual, like with your show, I did no research, so I have no idea what we were doing. But he was superb. He was really nice and so self-deprecating, breath of fresh air, honestly. Because otherwise, I get very scared with artists. Yeah, sorry.
So, Anand is the guy who basically wrote Bahubali, the book Bahubali, which got translated. Yeah. And so, very fair. And he came on Cyrus Says, and it was a really fun episode. And he mentioned something about, I think, and this connects to the Hello Friends conversation. Is the dramas in India is essentially seven lines per episode. And the rest is just all this, whatever.
Cameras,
that doesn't work. Yeah, that which is the shorts and all. That doesn't work for comedy. You can't say that मैंने उसके हाथ में संतरा डाला और वो स्क्वीज किया then shots of everybody. That doesn't work for comedy at all.
Why would you choose that line? Look at your subconscious. What a sexually repressed fuckhead are you at the end of the day? I mean, where did that come from? Santra aur maine squeez kiya. And one Santra, you're a sick, weird man. I want to do the show. I'm done, bro. I'm done.
Okay, by the way, I'll just read some super chats, okay? And then, which is like, there's some 20 people on super chat. Minion BOB says, the week that wasn't Fridays at four good old days when news wasn't comedy and comedy wasn't news.
That's true. That line blurring is by the other gentleman, not us. We are just out of work comedians trying to do our bit. But I think he has crossed the line into comedy in such a big way that we have become redundant. Because, I mean, honestly... should we become serious? You think, Saurabh? That's one way out.
Go for
us
it.
Now. Just you, we tell the serious news. There is no murder. There was no murder. There is no evidence. I mean, why don't I try that? Should we try that this week?
Yeah. Yes, I think so. But we tried it this week. Is that? This is what we tried to do.
Saurabh, very often they just keep showing the papers and talking about data. Donald Trump does this as well. Just give you a figure with no backup. 33% Americans have recovered. Nobody, where do you get the data from? That's it. I've just got it in my head. Let me share it with you. That's it. I love that guy. He's special.
But you know, the tragedy is that four people over here who are sending you super chats think he's funny. The rest of the country doesn't think he's funny. They think he's dead serious and he's a savior. That is the problem.
I've got a theory. Alpha males are very dangerous. All alpha males, because they don't listen to anybody else. So you have to give them the right responsibility, like a watchman. Alpha male, very good. You stop people, you know, not think too much. Ah, I kill you. But running country and all, alpha male, not good. We have lots of different people who can run country together in democracy. Alpha male, not needed. Alpha female, even worse. I'll not even discuss that right now because I'm married to alpha female, so I know what that's like. You can see the marks. You can see the marks, or if you don't look, don't keep Nayanthara away from the cameras and all. I don't want to see the pain, the anguish. You think this beautiful face was...
Yeah,
push her away. Where's the wife, by the way, Salah?
I don't know. I try to forget these things.
Weekend pe shaadi kaun karta hai bhai?
I removed my ring, by the way, very long back because I can't say it. I wore it for a year and then I was like, forget it. Yeah.
I wore it somewhere else, so it just fell off.
I'm just trying to understand. Because
it doesn't remain the same.
I thought it would get stuck. No.
I may have to demonstrate, beta. Do you have another show? You'd be lucky if you still have this one. Yeah.
Okay.
Kunal, you're the only guy, ironically.
Yeah. No, go ahead.
He's the only one with a ring. We are the married ones, and he's got the ring. Show your ring. There you go.
What are those for?
For money, man. For what else?
But you spent money on them.
I did.
Yeah. But has it worked though?
This is a guy who got 3 on 100. No. You think it's difficult to fool him? Ah, beta, ye peno, ho jayega. Bhagya. Nothing.
It hasn't worked, but now there's fear to take it out because it may go the other way.
But listen, so obviously it worked because you have a Gajarala painting behind you. And he's, as we've already discussed, a very famous French painter. And
he's not suffering. Saurabh Pant, it's a 2-bedroom house, single male. No strings attached compared to you, who is looking after your parents, your kids, and everything else around you. So, brother, this guy's gotten away scot-free. He lives in Prabhadevi, central Mumbai. Everything is good. He has ACs everywhere. He's got a big car. He's got a chauffeur. He's got a super female help who's quite attractive. I don't know what's going on there. So, you know, no shiny, whiny out here. You know what I'm saying? You know, I mean, not to judge. Well, that's a class issue. Well, why should you have a class issue? Romance is romance. Who are we to point fingers, right?
I think it's disgusting that Kunal Vijayakar is living in a 2-bedroom house by himself. I think one of those rooms at least should be turned into a COVID facility. Like, at a minimum, we should contribute to society. At an absolute minimum.
Or even better, we send him to a COVID facility and this house is used by underprivileged people. Why waste that beautiful house? Yeah.
Yeah, I mean,
he just needs a tent with a bed. You're right, Saurabh. I respect you so much now.
There you go.
You're a pious and holy person, charitable man. I appreciate your thinking. And we both want to save.
Saurabh Pant, how does this compare to a 4-bedroom, 3,000-square-foot, two-level house in Malabar Hill that Cyrus lives in?
But he has two wives and seven children.
He's the chief minister.
No, but Cyrus has like two giant dogs. You have like two really like horse dogs. Like you have those big
I
dogs.
Thought you were going to say testicles. I thought, two ka kya hoga? Two ka kya hoga? He's 56. What's there? Inke batao. Two. Oh, damn.
Okay, I'll just read these super chats. Quickly because people are getting all angsty. Swati Baveja says, hi, Saurabh, been loving these sessions. Sorry, I'm not being able to pay regularly. That's totally fine. Please tell Cyrus that I love his podcast, especially Cock and Bull episodes. So that's the question I had, which is that, you know what I think is very smart of you guys, is that you have one show which caters to slightly older people, which is Week That Wasn't, and then you have two podcasts which cater to youths and young people, you know, 16-year-olds like myself.
Yeah, right.
have you actually noticed that? Is that true? Is that like a legit thing where like younger people gravitate more towards the podcast?
No, I don't. Personally speaking, I really don't care what age people. I don't completely believe that whole age thing. You know, they tell you 50 million people, they have to be under 30. I think people have a commonality, and those commonalities right. will bind them together. That's why we can get along with a 57-year-old man like Kunal, because you're 38, I'm 49, he's 57, but we can all have similar commonalities and listen and watch the same things. So beyond the teenage sort of group, I believe that people will come together from that. So if they like our show or whatever we're talking about,
yeah.
I hope it's the same type of people. No, you don't talk now. Because you're
No, keep quiet, Cyrus. 1 minute. It's also got to do with the function of the medium, okay? Television medium is now watched by older people. If the same show was to be on a YouTube channel and change slightly with the same content, I think it would start attracting a slightly more digital audience, but we are on TV. The TV channels themselves are.
Well, come close. I'm going to cover your face. Come close. Yeah. Okay.
You can't cover my face from there.
That's true. I don't have enough material. No pun intended.
There's a debate between the two of you with regard to the laugh track, which Cyrus keeps talking about all the time.
I hate it.
And all the sound effects. And Kunal, you like it. So what do you think is the reason for keeping that?
I'll tell you the difference. The difference is sort of people like you and me, whether we are successful comedians or not, we're those jerks who want people to laugh at us. Like it's there in our DNA from childhood. So we want that validation from wherever we go, even in the airport or outside with the watchman, you crack a joke, but you like that. Kunal doesn't come from that school of art, so he struggles. He wants to warn people that it's a joke, you know. He doesn't want to take a chance with anything. So he has to warn people, the ye hai joke, is point pe laugh karo. Shekhar Suman mastered that with that little bit where he'd wait. He'd say, ha, to aage jaake, mar diya! And then, immediately. So he mastered that, but that's a self-track. I don't mind the self-track. Kunal, take the laugh track out. Saurabh is younger. He's telling you it's just not working.
Arey, Baba, it's the nature of the product, okay? It's the medium. Some shows are with laugh track or without laugh tracks. Our show has been with the laugh track. What I to put drum rolls also. Forget laugh track. After a joke, there's a drum roll.
One
minute.
We have never made a joke that funny that it deserves a drum roll.
That's why
you say that, because that draws attention to the fact that our joke has got no quality. But another drum roll for that. Don't do that. That's like ugly men who, you know, start putting tattoos all over and, you know, having all this jewelry and stuff. And I had a pal called Rishi, who was really ugly, and he used to put all this stuff on his face, and we used to go out and everyone would stare at him and laugh. If you're not very good looking, you're just pointing out that, hey, look, I'm not good looking. Now I'm a freak. So I think stop the drum roll. Saurabh is being very charitable here. He thinks it absolutely sucks. And Saurabh, will you just talk like a man now and stop hiding behind me?
Listen, Kunal, okay? I think you should remove the goddamn laugh track, Kunal, okay? Listen, I have testosterone in my chest and I will squirt it all over the show.
One MCBC. One MCBC will help here.
My children, born child.
MCBC.
I understand the logic where it's like, specifically because slightly older people are watching, they're used to having almost it spoon fed to them. Like, that's why, have you guys ever thought of having I remember when we were doing News on the Loose for like whatever 2 years we did it. One of the thoughts that we had was that every week we're going to get 20 to 30 people to watch the show live and then record that. And also specifically with Cyrus, dude, by the way, Cyrus hosting a show is a fucking delight. Because there's 45 minutes of...
Let me put it louder. Maya, put it louder. Sorry, go on.
And then there's 15 minutes of stand-up where people are like, can we go back to the riffing? See, I eventually did an insert.
I can't find the volume. Huh.
But so have you guys ever thought about like getting in 20, 30 people to watch the show and keep that as
no,
like
we did that. We've had... But the thing is that most people we get are non-English speaking. So what happens is I make the joke, I say two men in a bar, this and boom. and then they nothing. So then he puts a laugh track. So it's a failed experiment.
No, no. So you say basically, technically recording the people live on the show.
Yeah.
Well, it's difficult, yeah, because we shoot things separately, you know. Also, it's because
we've done specials and all where we've had a crowd. We've shot in university. We've shot in the old CNBC studio for 100 special, 200 special, all that. And that was nice because even when they, you can play off the actual, you know, sometimes they're not laughing. They're always like, what a crappy joke. You can still play off all that. Now, so the real moment happens. But my friend KV, he's like Amir Khan. He wants everything done properly. Nothing left to chance. He defies art. He just defies it. He doesn't want art. He just wants maths, which he hates. What an irony. What a paradox. Really amazing. Well, I've given up. You know, he just won't listen. And under him, he's got a now mini Kunal called Mohit, who does exactly what he says. So he's worked it all out. Sorry,
it's
sort
like
of.
A fiefdom. It's a fiefdom, it's a fiefdom. Kunal Vijayakar
nepotism
is, like
is the right word. Nepotism is the right word. Yeah.
Yeah, Mohit and him are related. I don't even know who Mohit is, but I think they're related.
Well, they do look alike. There's a strong resemblance in the sense that they both are between 95 and 100 kilos. But other than that, not really. Is he heavier than you now, Kunal?
I don't know. I haven't weighed him. But we are two Marathis that been on the show.
Okay, I'll just take three super chats and then I got to talk to Kunal Vijayakar about a movie that I loved. Thanks a lot to Gahode and Hitesh who talks about Yeezy Foam Runners. That's cool. Karan Makim, thanks a lot. Jisha Vadikar, looking at Cyrus makes me happy. Reminds me of good old MTV days. And Kunal is so cute.
Vadikar, from the family? Both. From the illustrious Vadikar family? Is she from there? India
Jisha,
captain 19...
Illustrious one. I know it's with an I instead of an E, so highly unlikely.
No, okay. But sometimes they do that purposely. Like Don Bradman's son changed his name, surname, because he didn't like the spotlight. Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So even Kunal, change? Kunal changed his surname. Kunal, you don't keep Presley now, no? Yeah, he doesn't keep Presley. No. It was too painful. Everybody, Elvis, your dad. Elvis, your dad. God, your mom must have been her. You know, like, it's terrible.
Given quite a lot. He's like big fan of Cyrus. Cyrus, you mentioned Joe Rogan many times during Cock and Bull, but actually your podcast comes closest to being the biggest podcast. Your rants / conversations are awesome irrespective of the subject. So lots of compliments.
I'm wondering because I couldn't have done it, so there must be somebody then engineering this for us. Just check with Mohit's whereabouts.
Joe Rogan, generic fans. You like Joe Rogan?
I do. I've been listening to a lot of podcasts because this government put us in lockdown for some reason, which I can't accept and understand. But the thing is that he got 100 million on that deal, which you obviously know about Spotify and all that. After which, everyone started taking him really seriously. You know, before that, he was just the guy and the people who followed him. But then he suddenly became 100 million. I love money. Money just gives so much relevance to a person. After that, he's like podcasts. You have to use him. You're not allowed to not.
Listen, after the 100 million deal with Joe Rogan, I had a friend at Spotify and I'm like, hey man, I'll accept much less. Take my shitty podcast and do it. And they're like, not right now, we don't have money. I'm like, I can't be Jay Rogan anymore. That's my whole aim in life.
But they invested that money immediately, apparently made some 5 billion in stock overnight.
Really?
Yeah, the stock went up or some crap like that. They all made money. Nobody lost money in this deal of 100 million. Yeah, only you and me not getting paid extra. Win some, lose a lot. What can you do?
Okay. Sachin, Shriyan says, hi, Kunal and Cyrus. Please tell us more in detail about Hello Friends. We've already spoken about it. I think this is a very old message. Anshit, again...
But can I just say that Ajit Pal was a really nice guy? Because I think we are just pillaring him all the time. It's like Genghis Khan in the times he was not more brutal than anybody else. Or the same thing as Ajit Pal in the early 90s or the mid-90s. I mean, people were ripping off the American television things. They're just doing it. It's just his bad luck that after 21 years on the internet, somebody found it and it seems really uncool and, you know, went
and
for
you
it.
Know,
so I don't
not, know, not to act defensive, but it was shot. Both the one that I'd done earlier and Hello Friends was shot the way sitcoms should be shot. Not the way they run on Sub TV today, because the timing and all is completely haywire. But this, if you just watch
Kunal's
it...
Kunal's contract with Sub TV to be cancelled?
It's got a multi-camera setup. It's edited online. It has the right timing. Everything as a sitcom does. Which people stopped, huh? People stopped using multi-cam for sitcoms.
But why did you say Sanjana's name 5 times in the clip that went viral? Why do you have to say... It was all, the script, it said Sanjana, and then whatever the line was. Why do you say Sanjana, 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 Sanjana? Why do you keep saying her name?
Because I'm an old-fashioned actor who needs to draw the attention of the other actor, stop her in a line, and then say my line.
And the other actor was obviously not paying attention to you. Why?
The other actor is you.
It was the actress. I'm not Sanjana. Sanjana was Simone.
Was she Simone or was she the...
You don't even know who the actress was. Who you're calling. I mean, you're such a bloody thorough professional. And you were don't blame the journalist.
Aparna. Wasn't she Aparna? Aparna, the baddie player?
Kunal, if you're not gay, you should be. This kind of disrespect towards women. You have no interest in them whatsoever. Huh. Sorry, Saurav. I know you're enjoying all this. Yeah.
No, but Simone or Sanjana? What I want to know is that, did you guys, like, when Ajit Pal came up with this idea that, hey, let's do a remake of Friends, did you guys go like, this is going to be the shit? Or were you like, this is going to change things? Or were you just like, let's just have some fun?
No. See, at that point in our lives, I was in my early 20s, he was 40. All that was on our mind was drinking. So we only wanted to know what time it pack up. I have my entire career has been, when do you end? I've never looked at what the thing is. I think that's a good way to go. You don't worry about mediocrity and all. I mean, that's it. That's where you are. And so we didn't look at the product. I never even saw the show ever in my life after it came out. But I do remember one bar night, we were under a lot of pressure. And we had to get out of there to make last time at Bombay Gym by 11, remember? And we had bar in the car technology. We broke all the rules.
Saurav has met us when we've been pounding. Now that we've stopped and I rarely drink, but there must have been times badly behaved. Very
38, drunk, Baba. He wouldn't be allowed in the bar. He's 10 years younger than me, 11 years younger than me.
Some bloody place he must have met
us. I met you guys at Bombay Gym. I was with my version of Kunal, which is another Kunal called Kunal Rao. And we went to
that was the press.
His dad was the press.
Correct. So you're saying, all free.
So that's how Kunal got us in.
Yeah, because it's all free for him. It's a typical nepotism, it's been going on for years.
He made us pay. I'm not even making this up.
Comedy is a difficult profession. He made you pay. I understand, but he made money on it. Everything was free.
Hey, Saris, I have two rumors about you that I've heard that I'd love to clarify. Okay.
Please.
One rumor was that somebody saw you were about to get on stage for some event somewhere. And you were at the bar downing shots of rum back to back. And they were like, and whenever I heard this, I'm like, shit, so Cyrus is doing these, even I should. This will help me.
I don't think so. Could I have
unlikely. First, Cyrus doesn't drink rum. One. Yeah. First, he doesn't drink rum. He drinks only water. He used to drink only vodka. And I don't think he's never knocked back alcohol before getting onto stage. Although, when we used to take plays and go travel with our plays, we've done major drinking before getting onto stage.
Yeah, for traveling?
Because you're out of town. You're out of town. You're doing a play. So I remember we were going to Pune, okay? And the 5 o'clock in the morning, Indrayani Express is what we were taking. We walked, you could do it. Walk onto the platform with a bottle of whiskey and a cigar in the mouth. Hammered, at 5:30.
We started drinking at 5. I remember this. This is a true story. Because that's when Bugs vomited outside the ashram. No?
Yes, outside Rajni
Gansom. Oh, God, Oof, terrible. So we used to have this thing when we do plays outside Bombay, we try and get drunk and see how badly it goes. Especially with comedies and these sitcoms where you have to go through doors and names. Doors and names, no matter how many rehearsals, you've got to be a little bit on the ball because it's a little bit here and there once they go wrong. So it's great fun. I think Kunal went off stage and then we had to find him. It took about 5 minutes. It was hilarious,
And when you're in a new auditorium, you don't know where the makeup room is. You're going to change your clothes. You're a little drunk. You don't know when you're coming back, which wing you're going to enter from. So, that was fun. But but never, otherwise, I don't think for an event, Cyrus was ever drunk before getting on to stage.
For MTV events, maybe when we're really partying and all that. I'm trying to remember, but definitely not for private events ever. And not for, I don't think.
Well, I think for one of those, one of the talent hunts.
For the Bombay Gym events, I would. Because that's not serious, we would just be fooling around.
Correct.
But that's when I, 2000, remember the guy fell off stage? Fareed Kareem or somebody fell off stage?
Yeah.
He just walked.
Yeah. Because he was drunk or because it's generally? Because the joke was that funny?
No, the lighting was a little odd and he missed something like that, I suppose. Yeah. But it was the best act of the night. I didn't want to go on after that. How could you beat that? A guy walks up, hello, ladies and gentlemen, pong. I mean, boom. What joke have I got? And there were 3 stars and then 1 fell. Oh, come on, who cares? Fall down. It's like the crowd used to shout in Malar, start the fucking music the moment you come on. And then if you don't start the music, they would start saying things like your mother isn't your father's dad. So I remember that it hardened us so much in the 90s doing all these college festivals that we could handle anybody because the crowd just abused you. In fact, I was not ready for praise. I still not good with praise. I'm much happier if people are, you know, taking me on a little bit. And I remember Nikhil and Nafisa coming on stage in somewhere for their AIDS concert, and the crowd started abusing. Get off! Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck your mom! This, that, and the other. And Chinnappa the Kurgi was like, I'm going to fight them. And I said, no, this is Bombay. This is normal. You have to go and accept the abuse. Yes, yes. Fuck me. Fuck my family. Yes, yes. Come on, everybody. Fuck. Side is a joke. And then they're all shouting. Then slowly stops. That's it. But for the Bangalore boys, everybody's polite and nice, a little more culture, sophisticated, it's a little difficult for them to accept. But it was hilarious. Yeah, I don't know why we came up with that story anyway.
I like this is a great response to hackers, by the way, where you just agree. Like, yes, I agree with your
Sorry, you haven't done the circuit of the college band, so maybe it's changed from there. You know, I mean, they were so bad. I was one of those guys off stage as well. You know, we would just come and because we want to hear Rock Machine play. And then you go to play the Doors, man. We want to hear Break On Through the Other Side, man. And that's all we want to hear. You know, nobody's going to listen to any anchor come on and try to do 2 minutes of stand-up. There was no stand-up. I was just trying to be funny because I'm me. So I'd come on and say, hey, guys, whatever. Lots of parking here tonight, which is really funny because there isn't. But nobody would laugh. They'd be like, fuck you. And some 2-3 really drunk guys are being able to like, shirt off and like they're coming to kill me. I'm like, why? I feed puppies. I like animals. Why would you kill me? Really? So yeah, it was quite a... when I look back, you know, Malhar has played a very important role in my life dealing with people on stage because everybody thinks you go to like Rawalpindi or you go to, you know, somewhere deep in the north where you're going to get beaten up and all. Actually, nothing is worse than Mumbai because Mumbai is creative abuse. Look at cricket. Who abuses more than the Mumbai spectator? Who calls, makes the racist comments or the monkey comments? All the famous comments you get, they're all from the Mumbai audience. So actually, if you survive a Mumbai audience, you can survive anything in India. This is my belief, having gone all over. In fact, you get much more respect in most places. The only problem is some place in the north, I wouldn't take Maria, Malaika and leave them there because, you know, then the dealers, you know, it's like going a little berserk. But beyond that, in terms of abuse, Bombay number one, the best ever. I mean, my parents, my aunts, my tribe, Parsis, South Bombay, you know, everybody in MTV, English-speaking people, whatever. I mean, everything has been abused. I got nothing. They can't hurt me anymore, you know. I'm just completely destroyed. Like, there's nothing left to hurt. So, yeah. It's been a fun experience.
We were doing a show recently at some place and we could see part of the audience, but it was like mostly in darkness. And we are in the middle and the set is going pretty well, right? And we've heckled and blah, blah, blah. And dealt with the hecklers, they're great. Everybody's into it, 45 minutes, everybody's listening. Suddenly, you do a joke and it's like supposed to be my closing joke. And it just tanks. And I'm like, what the fuck happened? And then the organizer comes and taps me on the shoulder and switches on the audience lights. And there are 3 dudes in the middle of a fucking big fight. Wow. A dude has a chair in his hand. Everybody's like, what the fuck happened? Like, I don't think any joke is going to follow that of a dude. And then I don't know if this has ever happened to you, where I spoke about the story earlier where I was doing a show, I think in Bangalore, I don't know where. And it was you can see the audience properly. But as a performer, you can see the first few rows quite clearly, but the audience can't see them. There's an Indian dude who I'm 150% sure was getting a hand job from his French girlfriend. And I couldn't acknowledge this because I'm like, I don't want to get them into trouble. So I just carried on seamlessly while constantly trying to avoid looking that direction because they both were in a very happy mood. I'm like, great. So yeah, you have something like that?
So his Rafale missile was getting tampered with, is what you're saying. Yeah. And you couldn't mention. I remember one really funny experience, which was unbelievable. They give you these announcements, you know, as a comedian, there's the worst thing, no? It's so bloody dry. You want to thank so and so. And remember that if you win this prize, you will get, and somebody shouted, your pop. And the crowd went berserk. So then I decided to wing it and I did everything with your pop, the whole announcement. I'd be like, and Parag Saris will give you an your pop, and your pop. It just went on and became a big hit. Of course, I think I got such a firing from the guys afterwards. Like, how can you make fun? I said, boss, I got nothing. The crowd decides. There's not much we can do, man. Your stupid announcements. Please tell them to give us, don't give us formal announcements. It's just flashing in the back. What are you going to do?
Yeah.
Brought to you by Piraj. Nobody's paying attention. They're shouting, your pop. The sponsor is destroyed. Oh, I should write down these stories. They're so much fun.
Yeah, there's a lot of the heckling story. Okay, Arnab Banerjee, my best friend, is here. Thanks a lot, Arnab. Yash N asked a question that I wanted to ask Kunal, actually. Yash N says, love Cock and Bull podcast. Kunal, your role was just awesome and Ab Tak Chhappan. How was it working with Nana Patekar?
Tell the wafer story. Tell the wafer story. It's okay. You can be a little indelicate. Tell the wafer story.
Well, okay. So, this is what I think about actors. Every actor is insecure, however big you are, okay? And while he was a great guy to work with, and I still know him quite well, I sense in one particular shot, okay? Now, I'm going to explain this very carefully. So we are sitting like this, one, two, three on the sofa. Me, another actor, and Nana. The camera is placed here. And I have one funny line in the whole thing. So I look at the camera and I crack one funny line, okay? So every time he called action, and I was about to say my line, Nana would bend forward to pick up a wafer from the table, which means he's blocking my camera. Okay, one more take, please. And I say, so you are the king of... He'd come into friendly. So I said, fuck, this is not happening now, okay? And I'm, so I did the obvious thing then. So he went forward, I went backwards. It was like... It was juvenile upstaging behavior. Yeah, but otherwise, he was good. I still go to his house.
But he really likes Kunal. He actually likes me as well.
And so this is what used to happen, okay? So he discovered that I knew Cyrus really well. Right. And I think he became my really good friend because of Cyrus. Hey, whoa, Cyrus ko phone kar yaar, you know? So he was a big fan of Cyrus. So he'd call up and say, Cyrus, Nana bolto hai, you know, and the whole thing should happen. It was quite good. And I took Cyrus one day to his house also. So we went, no, Cyrus for Ganpati.
Yeah, you've gone at least 4-5 times for Ganpati, yeah. And I've gone at least a couple of times.
I used to go every year. But
we thought he'd give us a role somewhere and all that. Nothing happened anyway. But just the point of the whole thing is that this happens in the theater. I don't know what happens with stand-up comics. You're basically alone. It's rare that you'll riff with 3-4. So you probably do it like, you know, like the way I don't stop talking or something like that. But here, they actually cover each other on stage and in front of the lens. And I love those stories.
It's unbelievable.
I mean you're Nana Patekar. I mean, he's poor Kunal. You know, he's a character actor. This guy's one of the big names of his generation, you know. And he likes Kunal. He genuinely likes it. It's like a joke. If you see them together, they get along.
I really like him, you know. So it's amazing how actors have their own insecurities. Like even on stage, it's very simple to upstage a person, you know. If you're having a conversation on stage, you take one step back. The minute you take this one, I have to turn around. That means backing audience.
Sort of after a big drinking night, I was kissing a girl and Kunal just came and started kissing her. You know, you don't do that, bro. You don't upstage.
That's very unprofessional.
Yeah. She was 79 years old, so I shouldn't use the word girl, but still. I remember that she forgot her teeth after that. Kunal, you were nice enough to return them the next morning.
It was stored behind Kunal's. He had an extra set of teeth for 2 days. Stuck on the ear, right. Eating and all. Yeah, it's nice.
There you go. Little foreplay, which is went all right.
Yeah. No, but Cyrus has always liked older women. Cyrus has always liked older women. And older means older.
Right.
I got no problem with that. I like the ladies. He doesn't know what to say. His wife's in the background. His daughter's just outside the door. And he's thinking, I like all women. Why torment me?
All ladies are good, no matter your age. Okay.
Be careful. Show some respect. Gender bias. Huh?
Yeah.
But I'm allowed to say anything about women.
I'm just curious about this Nana Patekar. Did you ever speak to Nana Patekar about this wafer incident or no?
No.
Because he's got a great sense of humor. He could have.
I don't want to. Why? I'm non-confrontational. I don't like.
Gaurav, he's a great guy to work with and to hang out with. He's a great guy. He's great fun for us. It's not like, I'm sure he's difficult with some people and all, but there's no complaints. A good fun guy. But these little things are there. It's important that they're there. That's what separates people. Without them, how do you remember anyone? Oh, lunch. Okay. I'm getting a lunch call. How long, Saurav, before we have to feed the animals?
I think like 10 minutes. So when do you want to head? Okay. I can end whenever you want.
In 6 minutes? Seven minutes.
Cool. Let's end in like 6 minutes. We'll take 2 more questions and then we'll bounce. Okay. There's a lot of super chats. I'm just going to read your names because there's too many stuff, things happening. Rajat Shubhra Mukherjee, thanks. Rishk, thanks. Karthik Sharma, thank you so much. Bose Baba, big fan of Cyrus, stays on IBM. Dude, there's so many people who are big fans of Cyrus. Even I enjoy the podcast a lot. By the way, my favorite guest on your show, the favorite person to deal with Cyrus talking a lot, Kunal Rao, came to you on your show and he had a whistle with him.
Maybe twice.
Yeah. But he used to
The thing is, because we are veterans and old, whatever, 70s performers, all the younger guys, of course, now younger guys, you guys are also aging, so it's all in perspective. But the first time you meet someone like Kunal, he's a little, you know, he holds back. He gives you a little more extra respect and all. I think by the second time, he was giving me a real mouthful. And I think we've called him on for cock and bull also. So it's more than, that's why. Yeah. So once he was familiar, he's a different guy altogether. He's abused me and used whistles and, you know, flashed and removed his testicles and put them on the table, all that. But there's a big difference between the first time when he was, you know, I won't say patronizing, but they treat you with a lot of, you know, I grew up watching you and, you know, the usual nonsense is all untrue. What kind of man is going to watch another loudmouth? Doesn't make any sense. But I, the amazing thing is that entire comedy group that comes that we've talked, the next generation, your generation, the one after, not one of them irritates me. And that's upset me because I was hoping they would irritate me more as personalities, but they're actually quite nice. So that's sad.
Like irritated, as in like,
this is a side, like to, homosexual moment.
To shit on you.
Sorry.
I thought
I just not like them, but I tend to actually like most of them. I can't think of anyone who's irritated me, and I've gone back thinking, what a prick. Kunal, have you as any of the younger generation of comedians irritated you?
No, not really. And
I know amongst themselves they fight. I won't take names. Papa CJ has been on. Somebody else has been on. I know they go to their camps and they don't get along and all that crap. You had your own internal politics, Saurabh. We have investigated the whole thing about the East India Mutiny and who was the Mangal Pandey, who was the British. Not clear. But at the end of it all, we didn't get a bad vibe, unfortunately. I think they just think that we are so fuck all. There's no need to feel threatened by the oldies. They just treat us nicely.
We have somebody who's been on your show quite a few times, and we're just bringing her on for just the last 5 minutes. She's been on your show multiple times. Here's Tanish Surka.
It's excellent.
Last five minutes, she will come. She's come. I think she's trying to figure out her.
Kaniz.
Hello.
Without teleprompter. Kaniz, who is the greatest teleprompter actor you've ever worked with?
None other than Mr. Vijaykar.
The best.
She forgot my name. For a minute, she forgot my name. Vijay.
Kunal, you're not known by your name. You're known by your face. Your face is one of the seven islands of Mumbai on its own.
Vijaykar is the best
teleprompter actor of all time.
Hi, what is a teleprompter actor? Teleprompter actor is like, is this a compliment or is this a mid-side story?
No. There's no judgment. Sort of no judgment. Understand the concept. It's like test match, one-day match, T20 match, a different concept. So the teleprompter actor now is this gentleman who doesn't like to do any ad-libbing, who doesn't like to go off the script, who, if you move the line, will just say that next line. And whatever you're saying as an actor is ignored because he just wants to read his lines. Yeah. It's a special talent. It's a great, you can ask. And Kaniz is the antithesis of that. So it's poetry in motion to see them together. Here's one riffing and freewheeling. And here's one who, if you go one word off, his eyebrow goes up and he feels uncomfortable and sweats and then starts scratching his balls and then, you know, doing pelvic thrust towards the wall for reasons nobody knows.
Which is not completely true.
And every time we do an event, it's an event where I do all the talking. He still wants a teleprompter for what I don't know. He doesn't have to say anything. He just has to mention whatever the damn thing is. You know, can we get a teleprompter? I feel more comfortable.
No, but I appreciate the teleprompter. Thank you, Kunal.
Your teleprompter was needed for Hindi.
For all the non-Hindi stuff, I need a teleprompter.
No, yeah. Well, that language that you spoke, which is whatever it was, is special. sirf usme baat karo abhi, please.
No.
And the video, which still does a circulation every year, it becomes goes viral again, and then it comes back again the second year, and 6 months again it comes.
I just so that five or six of your videos, that's the most out of all of us are viral for some reason. So either you're really sexy,
My favorite video is the one with me and Kunal where we play Gujarati couple. I think that's like one of my favorite videos.
What kind of actor needs a teleprompter to read out your name?
Just to say Falguni. I mean, I have to draw the line on that. Yeah, I won't do it. Teleprompter's off. Just have to say Falguni. That's it.
I got to ask all of you this question about Week That Wasn't. So, Tanis, you were on Week That Wasn't for how long? Like, are you still continuing?
She's still on. We just don't have budget for her.
No. I said I would come whenever. But we start. I was there from the beginning.
You started the show?
Second week.
No, I was there.
So, First episode, she was
first. First
week. I was in the pilot.
She was in the pilot. We only
what did about not the Channel V girl.
She shot the packaging and then they refused to let her be cast with you.
Right.
So
and
the
coming immediately. Yeah.
So I was supposed to come like monthly or something. I'd just be a guest, like a weather woman every now and then. Yeah. And then the other girl wasn't allowed to do it because she was contractually obliged to another channel. And so they were like, will you play all
Juhi.
The parts?
Juhi.
Yeah, Juhi. Juhi Pandey.
Juhi Pandey. Oh,
right.
Yeah, okay.
So
he said Juhi Pandey. Focus on him now for a minute. What the hell does that mean? It's like, I wrote for Juhi.
Juhi for a lot of Channel V scripts. And every time there's something out there, she's like, no. I'm like, but do it, no. She's like, nah. She's very sweet, by the way. I wrote a lot of really shit scripts for her, and she had to endure a lot of that. So I completely, everything I did, I was a writer for Channel V for a long time. I used to write for them. And there's a lot of, and I used to be the guy, Kunal, I used to be the guy who used to write like, hello, this is Vijay Anushka. Welcome to Channel V. And I had the same problem with a VJ. I don't want to name the VJ who had to take 17 takes because she forgot the name of the show. There was a show called Club V where we used to go to different clubs and review.
Just Google Club V. Who was the VJ? Quickly, Google it.
VJ Anushka. You just said VJ Anushka.
I can do it right.
But I wasn't VJ Anushka. Yeah, that's why I said VJ Anushka. Intentionally, Kaniz, I'm ahead of the game.
I'm Googling this.
And Anushka wouldn't bother about all this. She just said anything she wanted. She was worse than me. Don't worry.
But yeah, tell me about Week That Was. What is the how did that happen? Because you had was it your first first regular job in
we saw her doing some improv in a theater group at the Royal Bombay Yacht Club.
The same temperature thing she did. Yeah. She did the Hindi Tapmam reading in English in Hindi. It was hilarious.
She did a Hindi, which was terrible in 2006.
Yeah.
Which is now, I believe, you can speak Urdu fluently.
Yeah.
No. Adab, adab.
And she was really funny, man. She was really, really funny. Shit. We laughed.
There's no one like Kaniz, Saurabh. I don't know if that's a compliment. There really isn't. And unfortunately, we have used so many girls here and there.
There
we have budget issues. And everybody says, Kaniz. She spoiled us because ours is a crappy show. The actor has to enhance it. It's not a greatly written show where, you know, the actor gets better because of it. It's the other way around. It's the singer, not the song. The bloody woman is cost too much now. She won't work for 2,000 rupees and a vada pav.
Look, I'm doing Saurabh's show for free. I'll do yours as well.
Bloody income tax officer ka influencer.
We're all doing Saurabh's show for free.
You just make one phone call and these bloody stars are jumping up and down. I heard Shah Rukh was dancing at your damn wedding. What's going on here?
What wedding? I guess Shah Rukh, like, when we were playing cricket downstairs for my building, I'm like, Shah Rukh, come. Hold the foresight. That's what he comes from.
And that you say...
Come on, this is the opportunity for everybody else to talk. Guys, jump in.
Now, I can actually talk now.
Okay, no, I have to go for lunch, so hurry up. Last 1 minute and action.
Kaniz, tell us once a fun this thing about working at Week That Wasn't. Because it's been 14 years, dude. I didn't know you would be on the show for 14 years.
14 years.
Yeah.
Kaniz, you have a boyfriend?
No, that's not my boyfriend. It's the guy who cooks my food.
Be careful, huh? It's okay if it's the same person who cooks your food and makes your meals. Huh. Kaniz, I've got a new phone.
Congratulations! Oh my God, it looks like a modern one.
Yeah, it is. What is it called, this phone? Nord. It's called a Nord.
Oh, wow.
You got a Nord.
OnePlus Nord. Nord OnePlus.
Rumor of
Nord OnePlus.
Cyrus,
who's modern now, huh? Who's in with the Jones, huh, boys?
Cyrus,
Nord One, up yours, Kunal Vijaykar, up yours.
Look, you want to eat lunch, I want to pee. Kaniz has the last word, let her talk.
You live alone, you can just pee in your room.
Can I come back? I'll come back in 2 minutes.
Never have old comedians for a long show because they have to pee.
See what happened? Kaniz, tell us your tales.
This is how it was every week on the Week That Wasn't. Exactly what it's like now. Just me, like, just laughing.
So
now getting upset with Cyrus every week.
Kaniz used to tease Kunal a lot. We used to really have fun. Yeah, break him down slowly.
Kunal and Cyrus are the only ones who've seen me through literally like my whole comedy career from the start. My whole like, even like every single relationship I've had, they came to my wedding. Like they were invited to my wedding like in 2008. Like they've just, it's amazing how they've
we
just...
We weren't called for the divorce.
No, I was there for the, I went and ate money food also.
Enjoyed as well.
You guys didn't really, gifted me really nice glasses.
For the divorce.
Yeah, even I thought that.
Can we have them back
for the divorce here?
Can we have them back if the marriage is not there? I mean, can we have the? I mean, isn't it wrong of you to keep it? I mean, isn't that like, I mean, that's wrong, morally wrong? Let's talk about this for a second. If your marriage doesn't work out, you give the gifts back. What the hell?
Yeah, but hello, you didn't pay for it. What is your problem? I paid for it.
That's between you and me. That's another story. Don't get into that. That's being petty. Don't be petty. This is a moral issue.
Yeah.
Saurabh, stay married. Otherwise, keep the gifts in the same wrapping paper. Because they have to go back.
All the gifts are already broken now. It's been 10 years. My children have had at it. They've destroyed everything. So, yeah.
Really?
But so I didn't know that. I genuinely didn't know that this is a 14-year connection. I thought that, like, now that I think about it. So, when Veer and me were doing that show, and the
same.
Contest is that...
You started 1 week after us.
Were 1 week after. And I remember when Veer and me were doing a show, I think there was a point where I was dressed up as a cop for some gag that we were doing. And Cyrus passed me by and he like, sir, kaise ho? And I was like, wow, this guy, is he like this? Is he thinking I'm an actor or a cop, actually? So I was confused. Till now, I'm confused about whether Cyrus is like this for everybody.
Saurabh, many actors are cops only. How do you think you get by? There's not that much work out there. Between Nakabandis, yeah. Kunal is a watchman. Nobody knows this. He does 8-hour shifts in Prabhadevi, then he goes, puts on his makeup, dresses like a South Indian politician or a female politician or a Bengali politician, and he comes back. But Kaniz.
Yeah, Kaniz, I just want to hear one fun story about week that wasn't or anything that happened. That's all. No pressure on you.
Tell them
this is the
how
end of
even
the show.
Tempered and polite and nice Kunal is, and how invigorates everybody.
I don't know if I can. I can't tell this story, but it's one of my favorite stories.
This is not public. The moment Saurabh said we are on the show, his ratings dropped by 64%. So right now, there are not too many people watching. Say what you want. Go on.
No. I don't remember. Oh my God, there's a lot of pressure, Saurabh. I can't remember like
Come on. Do it right now. This is the closing of the show. This has to be the greatest story that anyone has ever told on the show. Okay?
No.
And if this... Okay,
I remember once I jumped out the window because Cyrus was talking too much. And so I jumped out the window and then Kunal was like, oh my God, no. And then he jumped out the window as well. And like, we're all like hanging from the CNBC building.
God.
And then Cyrus was like, what are you guys doing? So then he jumped out the building.
There's a hole in this story. The hole is... The window, it's Matt's. The window is so much and Kunal is so much. So the window can jump out of Kunal. The Kunal can't jump out of the window. Remember that.
And the office is on the ground floor.
Yeah. Which is an easy way to get in and out. Without security check.
Have you guys ever done a live show together? Like a live event together?
I've done one or two with Kaniz.
Yeah, we did some at NCPA for Ryle Padamsee.
No, we also done one.
Yeah.
I remember.
No, and IPO, we did one Kaniz. Kaniz. We did. Kaniz. We did a really drunken show at the Bombay Gymkhana. Remember?
Oh my God! That was the best show I've ever done in my life, by the way. The Bombay Review.
The review, yeah. Oh my God.
Cyrus, that was the best live show I've ever
done. This is a Rahul Bose.
How we drank. How we drank after that.
Oh my God.
The best drinking nights of our lives. Oh my God, really.
I kissed so many boys at night.
Wow, you're telling me. I had a few boys myself by the end of it. It was like too much. Oopsie.
That was the best live show. We did such... It was Jugal Hansraj and Rahul Bose and like...
Meher.
And we were just doing like dumb skits. It was such like old like... It was so much fun.
Jugal Hansraj was doing comedy with you
He's
guys.
He's very funny. He's a very talented guy. He's a very good musician. Unfortunately, after Masoom or whatever, that as a child actor, that it didn't really work out. But he's actually very talented and he's got a great sense of humor, great fun.
Yeah.
And we needed one good-looking man in our group. Now, otherwise, the girls don't come.
Also, it's all free. Now, the members have to ask. He's a member.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Only two non-members in that whole group.
Oh yeah, the non-members put it together, and then you guys, and then the members had to act.
And
it was so elitist. It was great.
The best part is Kunal played one of the Mangeshkar sisters and came into the Maharashtra sari and all that and stood on stage. I remember, and the brassiere fell.
My blouse opened.
And so I had to help him put it back while he continued. And again, you couldn't beat that, no? So the moment is gone, the crowd has gone berserk. Your dialogue is redundant. But you have to carry on as a good soldier. You carry on. And he's carrying on. Why are you here singing? Why are you singing so much? And he's putting the thing back. And I'm helping him. It's wrong in so many levels. Oh my
God. Wait, Sires, did you call it a brassiere?
Sorry, brassiere? Choli ke piche kya hai kind of thing, whatever.
The thing that I noticed from this is that Kunal Vijayakar, even in this moment, continues to stick to the script. He's like, let's focus.
<What's> the... Sorry. Above Mr. and Mrs. Mehta, there was a teleprompter. Yeah. And so, yes, it carried on. There was no change.
No, but listen, sir, I've got to thank like Kunal and Cyrus for noticing me.
Me. I was the one who said, let's go with Kaniz. He had already lost interest.
Because of them, I'm actually like, I have a career in comedy. So.
Just me. I did nothing.
And Kaniz, Cyrus will always take credit for everything I've done, okay? Cyrus insists on taking credit.
Kaniz, I'd send him out of the room so that you could do your bit and perform as an artist. Because otherwise he'd go mad with instructions. And tell sort of how he acts out for actors. Who does that? Not since Kubrick has someone come on stage and said, now, Kaniz, you're playing this girl. You go, hi, what's up? And then he just overacts everything. And then it's in her head for life. Luckily, she uses that on her stand-up and improv and not in our show, for God's sake. Kunal, please, along with the laugh track, stop acting out for actors.
About being on the show for 14 years.
And we need a comeback soon, huh, Kaniz?
Please, you call me. I'm free. Please call me whenever. I'm completely Luka.
Done. Maybe I'll write you in next week.
Yeah, okay.
Stop acting like you're Premchand. I'll write you in next week. I am the great writer. You're just a fucking hack who goes on the internet and robs people's jokes and puts laugh track and then show it to your family so they think it's great. It's not great. You're not great. You failed maths twice. 5 and 3.
I think on that note, I think let's end the show. I know Kaniz came a little towards the end. I know Cyrus has been dying to eat. So, by the way, this has been real fun
the
time.
The family.
Oh. Yeah, the family. I don't know. They, when I
hang with la familia. Thanks, Cyrus.
All remixed right now. So thanks, Kaniz, for your drop-in slot of 7 minutes. I appreciate it. Thank you, Kunal Vijayakar. Thank you, Cyrus Brocha. Week that wasn't continues on CNN and IBN. What is the date?
Saturday, Sundays. I don't know the timings.
Anytime they feel like, no guarantee.
It's on YouTube also. I just saw the 4 episodes yesterday. And Cyrus says, and Cock and Bull and all that
stuff. Is that why your hair fell off?
Yeah, I was like, shit! Why is he still not using the teleprompter? Kaniz, do you have anything coming up, improv battle or anything like that?
No, nothing this week. The improv battle is, I will start again next week. So now this week I'm just taking off, so nothing. Thank you so much, though.
You didn't win Miss India. What the hell are you thanking him for?
Kunal, anything coming up, anything you'd like to say? There's about 1,200 people watching.
Nothing. I'm fine.
Kunal, tell the truth. He's not fine. He's lonely. If anybody wants to adopt a 56-year-old Maharashtrian male with no talent, no interest, and no passion or desire for anything, he's the guy to go to. I put it out there. I'll do what I can.
Kunal and Cyrus,
thank you, Cyrus, so much. Kaniz, we'll come next week.
Next week.
Yeah.
See, this worked out eventually. See?
Thank you, Sarah.
It turned into like a LinkedIn meeting.
What we've done is we've retarded her career again. She escaped a week that wasn't to go further in life, and you're bringing her back to do rubbish again with a laugh track and a teleprompter and a fat actor who won't stick to anything that he's told.
OG all the way, original gangster. We are the original gangsters.
There's another word in colloquial Hindi which begins with C and ends with T. I think that's more probable for us, but
chat.
Whatever.
Something.
Okay. It's the second part of a parachute.
Choo.
You've got it, Kaniz.
Choo.
How dare you? What do you call me, Kaniz? Stand up. What do you call me? Damn you. Really? It's mother and then para. And then
this show's never ending, Saurav.
Yeah, I gotta go. Bye. Hey, Saurav, no, thanks. Cheers, man.
Is that Cyrus is the one who's been wanting to leave for 20 minutes and he's the one who goes on talking. He's like, I have to leave. And then he's like, wait, one more riff about parachutes.
I have no friends.
Okay, cool. Thanks a lot, guys. Thank you, Cyrus. Thank you, Kunal. Thank you, Kaneez.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
It was really fun. Thanks a lot. I'm just going to say some parting words to my homes out there in life. So thanks a lot to everybody tuning in. Again, today I have a show, which is, I should check what show I have before like announcing this. That was Cyrus Bush and Kunal Vijaykar. Follow them everywhere. They're on Instagram. They're everywhere. Tonight I have a show Saturday, Traveling Pants 2020, 8 p.m. And tomorrow I have Rant of the Pant, which is all about ranting on Sunday, which is again at 8 p.m. So two completely separate shows. You can get tickets for both. Get them on saurabpant.com. It's really fun. I enjoyed doing both the shows. And Monday, tomorrow there's a break. Monday we have Harsha Bhogle. Just, I forgot to announce that up top. Harsha Bhogle is there on Monday with Kumar Varun and Anu Menon. That's going to be a crazy fun episode. I think it's going to go on for at least 7.5 hours. At least 2 hours. So please come back for the Harsha Bhogle show. Tomorrow, there's no show because we're doing it on Monday instead. Then on, what is the next one? Thursday, I've forgotten who's there. I've completely, I think EIC is coming and Kenny is coming. I don't know what this lineup is. Wait, what is the lineup? Oh yeah, sorry. Thursday is Kenny and Sumukhi and Naveen Richard. And then Saturday is East India Comedy Reunion. And then I don't know what else. So there's a lot of shows. Shit, I should start actually locking down those days. You can also support the show on Insta, Mojo, and PayPal. I'll see you guys tonight if you're coming for the stand-up or tomorrow for the stand-up. Harsha Bhogle on Monday again. Thanks a lot for tuning in, guys. You make the show fun. Oh, wait, I should read some super chats, man. Lots of names I didn't announce only. Want to thank Rahul Mujumdar, Tushar, Krishna Somani, Nitesh Rawat, Chirag Shetty, Sharad KRS, Rohit Rao, Bose Baba I said, Karthik Sharma again, Rishk. Rajat Shubro Mukherjee, I'm sorry I couldn't take your chats because there's like 10,000 people who wanted to ask questions and then it's impossible to get a word in with Cyrus, as you already know. So sorry I couldn't get that in. I really had fun today, man. Thanks a lot for watching in. I'll see you guys on Monday with Harsha Bhogle. Try it with a stand-up. Thanks for watching. Keep supporting on Instagram, Mojo and PayPal and also get to the new channel which has snippets from this particular show. Goodbye. See you later. Thanks a lot. Bye.